Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is my new Monday blog. I got fantastic things to tell you. It's not about politics. I'm always attacking and abusing the people who are frauds and liars in this country. But and you know who they are by now. Let me talk to you about different kinds of ridiculous nonsense that goes on here that's almost as stupid and obnoxious as the low-life liars that we see in politics. This whole new obsession with health, which has given everybody an opportunity to rob your money pretending they're concerning with your health. They're not concerned with your health. They found out that you might be stupid enough to think that there's a difference between one product and another in terms of how it affects your health. So they start inventing things one after the other. This will somehow save your life if you buy this instead of something else. Like, take an example for eggs. An egg is an egg. You either like it or you don't. They used to tell you eggs will kill you because of cholesterol. Then they found out cholesterol is good for you, so eggs are good for you now, even though they were bad for you before. Because they told you there's only bad cholesterol. Now they found out there's good and bad cholesterol. So if you don't eat eggs and you don't have cholesterol, or your good cholesterol is a low number, you're in more danger than if you have low cholesterol. So you have to become a genius, have to be an accountant now with cholesterol to figure out how much good is good compared to the bad and how much lower should the bad compared to the good. But the whole philosophy they had for 100 years that cholesterol will kill you turns out to be a fake and a lie, just as low as Hillary Clinton. Or Barack Obama's phoniness about running for president without qualifications. There's no qualifications for this story either. This is a fake story all about nothing. Because the truth of the matter is, when doctors and nutritionists give you information, they don't admit to you that it's inconclusive or they're uncertain. They're always final. This is the final word. And they found out a great study proves this. Meanwhile, an hour later, they changed their mind and it proves exactly the opposite. Like, vitamin D was supposed to be at one time the best thing for you, now it's the worst for you. Vitamin C, how many years have you heard that there's nothing more important than having vitamin C? Linus Pauling with vitamin C, he lived to be 100 because of vitamin C. Now it turns out he would have lived to be 200 without vitamin C and it made no difference in his life. And all the latest studies prove that vitamin C is not only not especially good, but it's especially bad. They used to tell you, it goes out of your system and it doesn't hurt you. Now they tell you that while it's in your system, it probably will kill you. And the most dangerous thing you could do is take vitamin C. And these are the same doctors who swore for one thing and now have the opposite. And it's the same thing with almost every food you eat. How many times did you hear that coffee is the worst thing in the world for you? There's nothing worse than coffee. Then they found out it's the best thing for you. Now they don't know whether coffee is good or bad. The latest information is that, the worst thing for you now is coffee. Coffee causes cancer, and you two used to think it became, what could be more harmless than a cup of coffee? Turns out coffee causes cancer. Not only that, the caffeine keeps you awake all night. So not only are you dying, not only are you dying, well, what's the joke there? Not only that, it turns out that coffee causes cancer. Not only that, but the caffeine keeps you awake all night. But not only are you dying, so now you have to watch yourself grow. Turns out, would that matter if I fuck it up here? But no, the coffee, they found out coffee is the worst for you. Not only is coffee causes cancer, but it, besides causing cancer, the caffeine keeps you awake all night. So not only are you dying, but you watch yourself grow. And now they found out that they used to tell you that milk is the best thing for you. Now they found out milk causes cholesterol, and the worst thing for you is cholesterol. Now they don't know if it's good or bad cholesterol. Turns out to be you shouldn't drink milk because of cholesterol, because it enhances the bad as well as the good, and you shouldn't drink milk because of cholesterol. So everybody said, why don't you drink water? Now they found out the water in this country is so polluted that a half a glass of water is comparable to 2 milks, 3 coffees, and 4 teas. Now all you have to do is either drink nothing or pass away no matter what you drink. There's 3 ways to go. You don't even know what you did yet. You didn't even start eating yet. Without eating, just from these 3 different kinds of drinks, sooner or later one of them will kill you. Now if you start eating, almost everything will kill you. There's nothing that's safe anymore. Do you remember they told you that steak is the worst fear, that steak became the best fear? Now they found out that the fat in steak is good for you again. It was good and bad about 32 times in the last month and a half. And the same thing is true with almost everything you buy or sell. There's nothing. Now you've reached the point that if you touch anything, it could kill you. because there's all kinds of vibrations that come from trans fats that are transmitted to the things you touch. And every time you touch something, if it has too much oil on it, and somehow you put it close to your nose, the effect of it and the fat content and the dirt and the quality of it, that somehow it's smitten with materials that somehow goes into your system. It creates vibrations all the way through your body. And by the time you're 12 and a half, you pass away. There's all kinds of misery. Take a look at this. Now they have advertisements for eggs. They found out that people are so obsessed with these stories about what's good and bad, and they don't know the difference, that they decided they could make a living out of just creating different kinds of combinations of the same food. It was a time eggs were either good or bad. Now they said to themselves, there's a lot of people who think a certain kind of egg is better than another. So 3 million companies now are creating new titles for the same egg. And every time you go into a supermarket, you don't know which egg should you buy. You thought an egg is just an egg. Turns out there's 3,000 types of eggs. Take a look at this. There's large, go into a supermarket, and I looked at all the titles, and I brought this piece of paper with me just to tell you, to show you an example of how many eggs there are choice of. There's large, there's medium, there's small, there's spotted eggs, there's organic eggs. What's an organic egg? Do you know it comes from an organ? It comes from a chicken. It's the same egg as any other egg. But oh, they call it organic. Once people hear the word organic, they become stupid enough to become mesmerized and paralyzed. Oh, don't touch anything else because this will save your life. It's organic. Organic means it's not protected from cancer, tuberculosis, gonorrhea, or anything else. Because it's unprotected, and because it's not treated with anything that's antibacterial, it can't protect you in any way. Because all the anti-cancer medicines and additives that are put in certain foods are not put in organic foods, because they're left alone to grow freely. So what do you think happens? You collect more diseases from organic food than any other food. Now that's supposed to be the one that's supposed to save your life. Omega-3, nobody knows what it is, but it sounds so fantastically purative that everybody says, oh, let's get omega-3 eggs, which is the same as any other egg. It won't make no difference. Then there's cholesterol-free, but cholesterol is good for you, at least certain kinds of cholesterol. So you don't know if it's good for you to take it because it's bad for you. You don't know if you should take, there's caged eggs, there's engaged eggs, there's free-range eggs. Free-range means it's, don't get the wrong impression, it wasn't on a gas range, it was on a regular range. That means the chicken was free to run around, which means they collect good from birds, and by the time you eat this egg, you'll probably pass away. Now there's the eggs are, take a look at this, microbiotic eggs, egg whites, egg beaters. Now, I want to ask you a question. When you go into a store and you try to figure out which egg to buy, you know how long you'll stand there? For a month and a half. And the chances are you'll go dizzy or crazy. And the chances are if you even look at these things or even consider these things, you're nuts. Because you're letting them call you a moron for thinking there's any difference between one and the other. Just judge your own cholesterol number. Let your doctor tell you what it is. If your cholesterol number is okay, forget about all these different kinds of eggs and tell these phony purveyors of fraud to drop dead for stop lying to Jewish people.